Mahigit dalawang dekada natin siyang naging kabalitaan sa TV Patrol at naging kapwentuhan rin sa mga samut-saring kwento ng mga Pilipino sa Rated K.
Iba't ibang kwento ang na-achieve sa buhay basta't may tamang diskarte.
Nakilala sa kanyang katapangan bilang isang babae, kung kaya naman naging inspirasyon siya ng marami. She is truly a symbol of class, elegance, and courage. She is none other than Miss Korina Sanchez-Roxas. Pero sa likod ng kanyang intimidating image, marami pa siyang katangian na kabilib-bilib talaga. Ang kanyang kabutihang puso sa pagtulong sa ibang tao at ang kanyang kahangahangang pagmamahal bilang isang asawa at ina. Which only proves that women can achieve so many things in life and be their very best at these things. Kaya naman ngayong araw, humanda na kayong bumilib at ma-inspire sa kanyang natatanging kwento ng pagsisikap at pagpupursige to be a very successful woman. Miss Korina Sanchez-Roxas, makakakwentuhan na natin dito sa I Feel You.
Welcome back to I Feel You. At ang malaking katanungan ngayon ay handa na ba kayo mga kapamilya para sa isang umaatikabong kwentuhan with a respected woman na tunay na may case sa maraming bagay. Let's all welcome the one and only sa ating kamustahan with Miss Korina Sanchez. Hi, Miss Kay.
Hi! Hi, Tony! Hi! Hi! Hello!
Meron tayong special guest agad! Hello!
Special guest? Nasa na si Pepe? Parang kulang. Eto si Pilar. Hi, everybody!
Hi, Pilar! I'm sure that's what's keeping you busy. The twins.
Well,
I'm doing
too many things, Tony. Parang... Alam mo naman ako, hindi ako pwedeng nanay lang.
Tony!
Okay, so... but yes, I'm very busy with the kids also. I try to be hands-on. So, parang wala masyadong guilt kahit marami akong ibang ginagawa. So, I try to be there as much as possible.
So, how do you balance your time, Miss Korina? Yung time nyo for yourself, for the kids, for your work?
Well, because we're locked down, it's much easier. So I can schedule Zoom meetings and they attend my Zoom meetings also. Like now, I have an interview with Tony Gonzaga and Pepe and Pilar are both here. This is the boy.
Yes.
Tony. Tita Tony, hi!
Ay, para sa Mini Mar.
Mini Mar talaga siya. Pero pag sinabi mo
yung... Sumalit na, Mar.
Pero pag sinabi mo yung kumukunot yung noo niya, ayaw niyang pumayag. So, huwag ka masyadong sabi ng malakas. Sumisimangot. No. Ayun. So, I tried to, because they're twins, but it's not really double headache. It's really double the joy. Kasi syempre, meron naman tayong help. And talagang masaya ang may twins. O pababayaan ko na sila at naglilikot na sila, ha? Okay, get up there, plate na kayo, ayun.
So, if there's one thing na hindi pa namin masyadong alam sa inyo, is your childhood. Oo, so we would like to know, when you were growing up, what was really your biggest dream?
Oh my gosh, I wanted to be like you. I wanted to be a singer and artista. You know, because Tony, my mom, was a singer. She was a singer. Ang mga tari niya, sina Pilita Corrales, ganon. Sabay-sabay silang nag-start. And then, she got into business. So she had to leave the show business. So, pero growing up, nakikita ko yung pictures niya, ganon. So sabi ko, ay, parang gusto ko maging artista. So I pray to God, God, please make me an artista. But you know, as I was getting older, parang nahilig ako sa pagsusulat, and I told myself, parang I don't wanna play at roles. I want to be myself, but I also want to be on TV. So sabi ko, oh my gosh, so na pagkakataon, napanood ko si Lauren Legarda, and I said, I think I wanna be like that. I'm on TV. But I'm also writing. So I became a journalist. I became a broadcast journalist. Oo, ganun.
Do you remember your first job? Ano po yung first job ninyo?
Oh, well, my first job, hindi ko pa tinatapos ang college. I got impatient. Hindi alam ng parents ko. I wasn't going to school. Naku, wag niyo akong gagayahin, ha? Pero kasi, I was very impatient. Alam mo, pinupuntahan ko, nag-a-apply ako para maging newscaster. Kaya nga, 19 pa lang ako, I haven't finished college. I was already employed in MBS Channel 4 at that time. That was government station. I was the weather girl. Nalaman na lang ng parents ko, napapanood na nila ako sa TV. And pangako ko naman sa kanila that I would work and study at the same time, which I did. So I finished my college while I was working already. So that's my first job. I was editorial assistant. Parang ano, taga-timpla ng kape ni Melchanko, ganun.
So Miss Korina, you said you were 19 years old when you started pursuing this job on TV and you became a news anchor, you started as a weather girl. That was 19 years old. But do you remember the first time you fell in love?
Oh, bata pa ako na in love, Tony. Ewan ko, baka gayahin tayo ng mga bata. Pero bata pa. Ayoko sabihin. Before 19, definitely before 19, I fell in love. And that relationship lasted 8 years. All my relationships, ibig sabihin, ano yung relationship? Parang boyfriend, alam mo na kahit bata ka pa, at bata pa lang ako, serious na ako sa relationships ko, like 5 years, 8 years, ganun yung mga length ng mga relationships ko. So, yeah, I was young, but I was very responsible. I made sure I disciplined myself. I was home at a certain time. I knew that I wanted to do so much more. So that's why I married so late in life. I married past 40. Mm-hmm. In fact, I was saying marriage is not necessary for me. If Mar never asked me, I probably would have been okay not to be ever married. Ang feeling ko kasi talagang ang girl, ang babae, can be self-sufficient. And I think marriage and children don't really have to define you because you define yourself. Feeling ko ganon.
Ang ganda ng sinabi niyo, Ms. Korina, kasi ang topic namin ngayon is about girl power. And you are one of the most empowered women we know. You have a strong personality, you're very driven, you're goal-oriented. Is it hard for you to submit? Kasi di ba yan ang number one na sa Bible sa mga asawa, submit to your husband. For someone na empowered and strong personality, goal-oriented, is it hard for you to submit?
You'll be surprised because all my friends, Tony, are always so surprised and actually flabbergasted. They're all like in disbelief. Hindi sila makapaniwala pag napapanood nila ako dito sa bahay, pag nag-meeting ako dito, darating si Mar. Or, can I talk to you for a moment? Alam mo, iiwan ko yung meeting ko, ah. I am very submissive to my partner. And all relationships, even before my husband, to my boyfriends in dati, I've always been very maservisyo, I've always been very submissive, you know. Kasi at work, ako lahat ang nagdidikta, right? Ako lahat yung ito gagawin natin susunod. Ito ngayon ang gagawin natin. You know, in my personal life, gusto ko sumiksik na lang sa kilikili ng asawa ko.
So, how would you describe a woman's love? Ano ang nagagawa nito sa asawa or sa isang lalaki? Ang pagmamahal ng isang babae.
I really believe that man and woman were put together by nature and by the laws of man and God because talagang complementary eh. Or dapat complementary, no? I think the more you are supportive of your husband, the more siya lilipad, not just in his career, but emotionally, spiritually, intellectually, everything. We all need a partner, I think. I mean, it's important to have a partner.
For Miss Korina, you have such a strong personality. I'm sure you've experienced yung mga guys and mga manliligaw na sobrang nai-intimidate sa'yo, hindi ba? Bakit nakuha ni Sir Mar yung attention nyo?
Well, una, crush ko na siya. And over maybe a decade of being a reporter to Malacanang, parati ko siyang nakikita sa mga presidential coverages, o kaya kahit abroad, pag merong presidential trip, state visit, parati kami nagkikita sa ganon. So alam mo na, nakakatinginan, ganyan. Kasi ano ko rin eh, parang ganon din yung mold ko ng guy. When I saw him, sabi ko, parang okay to. And then I read an article about him. In fact, I was about to get married then already to someone else. And yes, not too many people know about I was about to get married. I actually had my wedding gown already started. We're always fighting. And I was doubting, and I said, wow, this is a very important decision. I have to be super duper sure. So why is it that when I read an article about Mar Rojas, parang I want to meet this guy. Parang teka muna, there's something here. And that's just an article in the newspaper. So
why, what was in the article? Ano yung nabasa niyo na nag-stand out na I want to meet this guy? Ano yung sinabi niya dun sa article na yun?
Aba, dinescribe niya yung kanyang ideal woman. And then, sabi niya dun sa ideal woman niya, I want a woman to be independent. I want her to have her own life. I want her to be able to do things apart from me. Sabi ko, naku, bakit parang dinescribe niya ako? Illusion ko, di ba? So for some reason, na-interview ko siya one time, but I had a boyfriend, he had a girlfriend. And ayun, parang nagsimula na doon. And then one day, nag-guest siya sa DZMM. And then he asked me out. He asked me out on a date. And when he asked me out on a date, nag-usap kami. And then, hindi na kami nagkita ulit. Sabi ko, bawal ang follow-up, na turn off yata sa akin to. So wala, di ba? Exactly 1 year later, tumawag siya ulit. Nasa Amerika siya. Ako nasa Pilipinas. Mag-a-Happy New Year lang siya. So, sabi ko, okay to ha. Happy New Year. Ayun. So, pagbalik niya Pilipinas, nag-date kami ulit. Ayun, tuloy-tuloy na yon.
So, nung bumalik siya sa Pilipinas after a year, he was already single nung time na yun, and you were also single na rin.
Yes, oo.
Di na natuloy yung wedding talaga dun sa...
Yes.
Miss Kay, kayo naman, ano ang secret nyo to keeping your skin young and beautiful? Oh. Dahil kung ano yung ituro nyo noon, hanggang ngayon, pareho pa rin. Ano ba ang sekreto?
Tapos, since tinanong mo, magpa-plug.
Happy married life!
Yeah, you know what? Kiti-kiti kasi ako, Tony. Parang walang bukas. Ganun ako talaga dati pa, no? So, when I retired from news, dati kasi bawal sa amin na magnegosyo, right? So now, I got into business and I'm very happy I did it earlier rather than later. I don't do frontline news, which means I can already do business. So, since kikay din ako, alembong, I'm always looking for good skincare. Sabi ko, bakit ba ang mamahal nitong mga pinagbibili kong mga, ano bang laman yan? So parang ay kulang ito, ay ito naman kulang ito. So you know, I formulated my own. It's called K-Magic. So this is now in Mercury, Lazada, Shopee. Marami nang bumibili niyan, but i-plug ko lang. Ito ang ginagamit ko talaga ha, every single day because I personally formulated all my products. So I have sabon, I have K-Magic has facial wash, has a toner, and the facial wash and the toner, ayan. There's an ongoing flash sale, 70% off itong K-Magic toner and micellar toner and facial wash. Ginagamit ko yan parati. So, yeah. Tapos, kasama yung skin cream. Yun, ang skin cream. I also developed my own. It's called Kalagen. Ayan. Hindi mo makita yung Kalagen. Ito, everyday ko ito iniinom. Thank you for asking.
And also, you posted on your Instagram. Miss Kay, you also posted on your Instagram yung mga bathing suit photos mo, yung mga super short shorts, super fit. How do you maintain that? Paano ba ma-achieve yun?
Noong una, medyo nahihiya ako sa sarili ko, Tony, kasi as a newscaster, balot na balot kami, di ba? Alam mo yan, di ba? And then I told myself, teka muna, bakit ba kailangan mukhang lalaki doing the news? I said, bakit ako balot na balot? Mag-sleeveless kaya ako, tsaka gusto ko body-fitting ng mga damit. Papauso ko yun sa TV Patrol. Sabi ko, teka muna, magpapapayat muna ako. That started my fitness regimen.
And now, you're a social media influencer.
Aba, like you. Diba? Yes, I'm very, very busy. I think even during lockdown, it got even busier because you're available to anybody any time of the day. So, the phone is there all the time. Anybody can get to you on the phone. Information is so fast, you can respond very fast. People earn a living going online. So it's here to stay. And I think bas-bas din ng Diyos na mag-reboot tayo. And this technology is something that can be used for good.